True story time. A friend messaged me the other day saying that they decided to replace their aging TV, and when they started looking into what to buy, they were immediately overwhelmed. They didn't know what QD Mini LED was, or Neo QLED, or OLED, or Direct Lit LED. Way too many acronyms. All the different brands have these terms on the box they didn't understand, and I could feel their frustration, right? They just want to know what kind of TV they should buy because they want something that's gonna last and they don't want to make a mistake. I get it. I do this for a living and it's frustrating, but I've got you. I'm gonna tell you about all the different kinds of TVs out there and tell you which ones to avoid and which ones you should be looking at for this big purchase you got coming up. By the time we're done, you're gonna feel a lot more confident and you'll be empowered to get this right. Hey there, I'm Caleb Dennison, and I've been a TV expert for the better part of 15 years. So you can imagine that even though I make all these videos about TVs, a lot of my friends just hit me up on text or in email and ask me point blank, what should I do? Thing is, to be truly helpful, it helps if I can take the time to explain what's going on in the TV space first. That way, when I steer them toward one TV or another, they understand why. And I thought, you know, if I just had a video that I could send them to watch, this process would be a whole lot easier. And then, well, it was immediately clear that I should make this video to help everyone, not just my friends and family. So today, we're gonna talk about all the different kinds of TVs that you can buy in 2025. We're gonna cover some of those terms and acronyms that you've been seeing if you started hunting for a new TV, or even if you just wanna get up to speed on what's happening these days. I mean, it's been a long time since HDTV was a hot buzzword. Now you got stuff like Mini LED and QD OLED. What's that all about? Well, I'm gonna tell you, and I'm gonna make it easy. So let's start with the fact that there are only two kinds of TV display technologies that you can buy right now. There's LCD and there's OLED. Each has its strengths and weaknesses, and I'll tell you about those. But under each of those two are variations. So let's just list them out really quick, and that's what we're gonna cover today. Under LCD, which most folks just call LED TV now, we'll talk about edge lit, direct lit, full array local dimming, QLED and Mini LED. Now, certain TV brands have come up with these clever names for these various technologies, and I'll explain all of that too. But when you understand those five fundamental approaches to making an LCD slash LED TV, you're 95% of the way toward knowing which kind of TV you want, and just as importantly, which kind of TV you don't want. Now, on the OLED side of the column, we're gonna talk about WOLED, QD OLED, and four stack or tandem OLED. Okay, so first, what separates an LCD LED TV from an OLED TV? Why do we even have these two categories? I feel like a lot of folks make this complicated, but it's really not. LCD LED TVs use a backlight. Think of it as LED strips that shine behind the panel to make the picture you see. OLED TVs don't have backlights. Each pixel lights up when you hit it with electricity. And since there is no backlight, OLED TVs tend to be extremely thin, like slimmer than your phone thin. That's one dead giveaway that you're looking at an OLED TV. Well, that and amazing contrast and the price. OLED TVs tend to be expensive, but they are getting more reasonable every day. Okay, so let's go ahead and run down these LED LCD TV technologies, and we'll start at the top of the list with edge lit. I'm gonna make this very simple. I really don't see a reason for anyone to buy an edge lit TV. Edge lighting became popular years ago when folks got obsessed with having ultra thin flat panel TVs. This after the plasma days where TVs were thick, heavy bricks. See, edge-lit TVs have the LED backlights as a single strip along the bottom or the top or maybe both edges of a TV. And then that light has to be spread out across the whole TV panel. So edge-lit TVs struggle to get very bright. The brightness isn't very even across the screen. They generate way too much heat at the edges, which can cause premature failure. It's just an outdated technology that's cheap to implement, but not worth the few bucks that you're gonna save. So my suggestion is just cross this one off the list. If you find out the TV that you're looking at is edge-lit, and to be honest, there are fewer and fewer of these kind of TVs out there now, I would say just move on to the next thing. Next on the list is direct-lit TVs. Direct-lit TVs are much more popular in the low-price TV category. This is where you have a grid of LED backlights behind the entire screen. These TVs can get really bright. The brightness is more uniform than edge-lit, so fewer hot and cold spots, and there's less of a problem with heat buildup, so they tend to last much longer. This is the baseline, least expensive TV type that I think you should buy. I'd say get a direct-lit TV if you just don't want to spend very much money, but you need a bright TV. I know a lot of folks like to use these inexpensive direct-lit TVs in places where they just want to have a TV, but the picture quality is not super important. You might put one of these in a garage, a spare room, a playroom, maybe get one for your RV. Now, the problem with direct-lit LED TVs is that they don't have very good black levels. In other words, they don't end up having great contrast. And that matters because our eyes pick up on contrast right away. The more contrast a picture has, the prettier it looks, and the more we love it. That's why full array local dimming was created. That's the next one on our list. Now, if you surf TV forums or YouTube comments, you may see full array local dimming referred to as FALD, F-A-L-D. What it means is that a grid of LED backlights aren't just on all the time, like they are with a direct lit LED TV. That grid gets broken down into zones that can be turned off or dimmed. That way, if you have, say, a moon in a night sky shot, the zone behind the moon can be lit up, but everywhere else the sky is black, the lights in those areas can be turned off. That gives you better black levels, thus better contrast, and an immediately more beautiful picture. If I had it my way, everyone would get a TV with local dimming, and the great news is, you totally can. TVs with full array local dimming are not especially expensive. So my suggestion is that you get a TV with full array local dimming if you can. The next improvement in picture quality comes from a very clever tiny little particle called a quantum dot. I have a whole video explaining what quantum dots are and how they work should you want to go check that out. But the quick and dirty version is that quantum dots help make TVs brighter and more colorful. Quantum dots are often abbreviated as QD, but most of the time you're gonna see them expressed as QLED. Now, there are exceptions, right? TCL calls it QD. Hisense calls their QLED TVs ULED. Samsung calls its QLED TVs Neo QLED. Sony calls its technology triluminous, and LG calls its TVs with quantum dots, along with other things, QNED. Now, if that seems like too much to remember, you're right, it is. So maybe jot it down, QD, QLED, Neo QLED, ULED, QNED, triluminous. All of them are good things. And it's gonna cost you a little bit more, but I'm telling you, it is worth it. If you want to enjoy the massive amount of HDR and Dolby Vision content out there now, you can get this stuff from streaming services like Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, Max, Disney Plus, and so many more apps. It's best to have a TV with quantum dots in it, helping to amp up that brightness and color. And finally, on our LCD LED TV journey, we get to mini LEDs. Mini LED is super simple, guys. It's tinier versions of the LEDs that you find in all LED TVs. And because they are so tiny, TV makers can use more of them and break them down into more zones, which means better brightness and contrast. The best LED TVs on the market right now are mini LED TVs, and that means they almost always also have quantum dots in there. So think of these as the top tier LED TVs. But the good news is, mini LEDs are becoming the norm. They aren't hard to find, and they are not necessarily ridiculously expensive. They can be, but TCL and Hisense both have super affordable mini LED TVs that you can buy. So don't think that getting a mini LED TV is out of reach, okay? All right, so with LED LCD out of the way, and hey, you know what? Let's take a break for a second. If you haven't already memorized all that stuff I just said, don't sweat it. You don't need to. You can come back to watch this video again. But you can also just kind of pause and decide now which kind of LED TV that you think you'd like to get and jot that down. Focus on that. But before deciding on LED TV, let me tell you about OLED TVs so we can see if they might be more up your alley. Like I said earlier, OLED TVs have no backlight. That means that they don't need local dimming. When their pixels are off, they're just off. They're totally black. So OLED TVs just come out of the box with the most amazing contrast. You'll notice it's really rare to see a review of an OLED TV where the reviewer isn't just praising it up and down. And that's because OLED TVs, by their very nature, are ridiculously beautiful. If you haven't seen one in action yet, you'll understand the second you do. But while OLED TVs have perfect black levels and great uniformity and no issues like halo or blooming, which is an issue where you can see the backlight peeking through on an LCD type TV, OLED TVs initially struggled to get as bright as LCD/LCD TVs. Now, those days are over. New tech has been developed to make OLED TVs very bright and extremely colorful. In fact, OLED TVs have the best color that you can get in a TV. So that leads us up to the three different OLED TV types that I mentioned earlier: WOLED, 4-stack or tandem OLED, and QD OLED. Now, WOLED is your standard issue OLED. In addition to red, green, and blue subpixels, these WOLED TVs have a white, that's the W, subpixel that helps juice up the brightness. You'll find WOLED panels in 2025 TVs like the LG B5, the LG C5. Some of Samsung's less expensive OLED TVs also have WOLED panels, and certain Sony models like the Bravia 8 use a WOLED panel. Now, my coworkers always laugh at me when I say this, but OLED TVs, including WOLED, start at a baseline of awesome. I can see Chris laughing right now. So even though WOLED is sort of the standard issue OLED here, it's amazing. And it's also a tried and tested technology. But TV enthusiasts, we're kind of obsessive and we tend to pressure TV brands to push the edge of the envelope. So as awesome as OLED may be, TV makers sought to make it even better. And that is where QD OLED comes in. You may remember QD from just a few minutes ago, stands for quantum dots. In an OLED TV, quantum dots help make the TV brighter and more colorful as well. They just do it in a different technical way. That's covered in another video that I mentioned earlier too, if you want to go and learn more about it. But anyway, quantum dot OLEDs tend to be more expensive than the standard issue WOLED TVs, but they are coming down in price already. QD OLED TVs have been my favorite for the past few years. I've given them all the top awards. Examples of QD OLED TVs that you'll find on the market are the Samsung S95 series, some of the Samsung S90 series, not all of them, the biggest ones aren't, and Sony's A95L, a top-rated and award-winning TV. There aren't a bunch of them, but they are the best. Well, hold on a second. QD OLED has been the best, and it might stay that way, but now there's the 4-stack or tandem OLED, which is an evolution of the WOLED that we just talked about. Look, the explanation around how this works is pretty technical, so I'll have to do that in a different video since it's so brand new. But all you need to know is that TVs that have this new 4-stack OLED technology, like the LG G5 and the new Panasonic Z95B, they are going to be some of the most expensive TVs, but they are also going to be super bright and colorful like QD OLEDs. See, WOLED didn't like getting upstaged by QD OLED, so 4-stack, which some folks call tandem OLED, was made. And now those two are at the top, 4-stack and QD OLED. They're at the top of the mountain. These are my absolute favorite TVs, and I generally tell people if they want the absolute best, you gotta get one of these OLEDs. Problem is, it's hard to get a QD OLED or 4-stack OLED any larger than 77 or 83 inches, which is still really big, but if you want a really big screen, even if you have the tens of thousands of dollars it would take to pay for it, it doesn't exist. You can get a big OLED TV. LG has a 97-inch monster that'll set you back about 20 grand. You just can't get these god-tier OLEDs in sizes that large. So there you go. Save this video so you can come back to it if you need to, but now you understand a whole lot more about the types of TVs that you can buy today, and you're a bit closer to knowing which kind is right for you. If you need a basic TV and it's not just super important to you, a direct lit LED will make a bright picture and do the basic job. If you want premium picture quality without spending much more, get an LED TV with local dimming. If you're more serious about picture quality, or you just want a daily driver TV that you'll be happy with for a long time, you need to get a TV with quantum dots in it, or QLED for short. But the best LCD LED TVs have mini LED backlights, so I highly recommend you look at those if you can. Remember, mini LED doesn't have to cost an arm and a leg. Look at the TCL QM7K or the new Hisense U7 series. You can usually get those at about 65 inches for under $1,000. If you are really super serious about getting the best picture quality, I suggest looking at an OLED TV. And if you want the absolute best, you need to get one of the few QD OLED or 4-stack OLED TVs that I mentioned. And that's it. You've got this. Thanks so much for watching. Hey, if this video helped you, that means it'll probably help someone you know. So share it with them, would ya? And click that thumbs up button so YouTube will help more people see this video. If you liked what you saw here today, please subscribe so that you can see more. I hope to see you on the next one. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like.